Welcome back to Team 203. I hope you've been a person of do, getting things done in your life to better your life and the lives of the people around you. Today on the episode, we are going to talk about St. Vincent. We're going to talk about making good decisions or good choices in this wonderful world. And we're going to talk about Pentecost. But before we do all that, let me just have a... Oh gosh. Let me have a taste of my yummy tea with eggshells on it. Maybe if I just...
Okay, Trusty. Let's get him. Get him, Trusty. Get him.
Yeah, that's a good Trusty. You're such a good doggy. Uh-huh. Hello? Are you a good dog? You're getting all weird. Yes, he said yes. And then we have a field here, so let me sing a song about our field. I've got a cow field today. Oh, gosh. Now I'm going to stick to doing what I normally do. I'm not a very good teacher. You got to forget my voice, too. A little groggy because of illness. Oh, and we should probably... No, we don't need to do that. Okay, so what we're going to do is talk about Pentecost. But first, before we do that, we're going to build a barn this episode. A barn. Right after I get that guy. Awesome. So this is where the barn's going to go. So let me just jump down here and give you a quick tour as I grab these experience points. We do have a lot of cows. Creeper. Get out of here. Creeper. Okay, we're not going to get far if I keep fighting these guys. So this is the barn. So I think, I don't know if I've decided if this was going to be the bottom level. Because so sometimes when I make barns, I make it so the bottom level is a place where you can actually have the two cows make a baby cow, and the baby cows fall down here. And this is where you go in to kind of make get all your meat. I'm thinking I might do that. But anyways, these are the three stalls. Each one would have some of the extra cows that you make on there. And we'll have a second floor where maybe I'll use some wheat and I'll bring the cows up here by pairs. And it'll look the same thing, except it'll be up here and you'll actually have stalls. But I might actually just keep like four cows in each one. And then over there, maybe I can do pigs because I got some pigs over there. We'll do four pigs in each one, or a couple pigs, couple sheep. And we'll make a nice barn. And then we'll have a hayloft above all that. Sounds good. And the hayloft, maybe that will come out over here. And then over here will be our entrance into this area. So while we're doing that, let's talk real quickly about Pentecost. So hold on one second. So again, the Pentecost. So Pentecost. So after Jesus left Earth, so he died and was resurrected. After he left, he was with them for a little while. When he left, the disciples kind of got lost without him. They didn't have him like around to teach them and guide them and pray with them. So the God sent the Holy Spirit down upon them. Gosh, there's creepers everywhere. That's not what the Holy Spirit said, by the way. But God sent the Holy Spirit down upon them, and that was Pentecost. And if you remember in the readings, which we're going to go to in a few minutes, the Holy Spirit came upon them, and they were all speaking in different tongues, and the picture in the book had all these little flame above everybody's head. And that was Pentecost. So let me just read that to you real quick as well. On Pentecost, Jesus sent the gift of the Holy Spirit to his first disciples. The event marks the beginning of the church. So that's pretty cool. Could you guys imagine that? I mean, if you think about it, let's say you had a teacher, he was teaching you for a while on Earth, and then he died, and then you were like, he's not here anymore. But then all of a sudden, you got you and all your friends that were following him had this special gift where you could speak in different languages, and you knew he was present. He just was present in a different form. That's pretty awesome. And even today, there are people that speak in tongues. It's kind of like a charism of the church that you don't hear about too often, but I've seen it before. And it's very interesting, and it's neat to see that even in the Bible, this is something that was done. And it's good to know that Pentecost, when we talk about Pentecost in church, you'll know that Pentecost marks the beginning of our church, which is pretty cool. So real quickly, while I'm getting these pillars up, let's actually do the Bible passage. The Bible passage is from the Acts of the Apostles. It's chapter 2, and it is verses 1 through 12. Yeah, and here, oh gosh, I need to eat food. So yeah, verses 1 through 12, enjoy, and I'll be right back. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 2, verse 1 through 12. The coming of the Holy Spirit. When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. And suddenly a sound came from heaven like the rush of a mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. And there appeared to them tongues as on fire, distributed and resting on each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. Now there were dwelling in Jerusalem Jews, devout men from every nation under heaven. And at this sound the multitude came together, and they were bewildered, because each one heard them speaking in his own language. And then they were amazed and wondered, saying, "Are not all these people are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear each of us in his own native language? We hear them telling in their own tongues the mighty works of God." And all were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others, mocking, said, "They are filled with new wine." So as we read, guys, you got to pray every day, you know, that the Holy Spirit guides you to make the right decisions. You know, that's the whole point. So, and remember, the Trinity is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So it's super important. And as you get older, I'm hoping that's going to be more a part of your life, is trusting in the Holy Spirit to guide you to make the right decisions. We have a story we're going to talk about in a little bit about that, or just about making choices and making good decisions. But first, let's go back to our... barn. Let's see here. Do we have slabs in here? I don't, but we're going to make some. Because we need slabs. I think we'll just do these and see if this is a good... So if you go in here and you do this... Let's get cobblestone too. And I made a staircase only because sometimes just jumping around, it beats jumping around all the time. But yeah, the barn is, it's neat. All you gotta do is just lay down your foundation. Lay down the foundation that you're looking for. Lay down the size of the little barn stables, of how big you want the area to be. And you can make them, you know, make a grid, make it 2x2, 4x4, 6x6, whatever you want. And then I usually just use some kind of log as the pillars to hold it all up. And what's also neat is if you make a floor like this, if you position these slabs so they're a little bit off, so you can see some of the ceiling logs, it just adds some depth that I think is kind of cool. And I don't know what I'm doing with that fence post there. I was just trying something different. It might be taken out completely. We might have to revamp it, but that's the fun part about this. It's kind of like drawing or coloring. That it's whatever you want it to be. So I encourage you, just when you're playing this game, boop, just completely be creative and think of even things you haven't seen before, block combinations, or think of something you can make in the game. I was looking at a Lego magazine the other day with my kids, and someone made a toilet. I know. Okay, stop laughing. Come on. They made a toilet out of Legos, like for the Lego person to actually use. And it was really neat because they used a white, door, like a car door, but they used it as the toilet paper. So it looked like a roll of toilet paper with some toilet paper hanging down. And the rest of the toilet was just common blocks that you probably have in your kit. It was just so creative how they came up with a way to reuse current things. So it's even in this game, it's interesting to think of different things you can do to get the effect you want, right? I think in my other world, I made a toilet, but I made it out of I used a trapped door. See, look at this. I used a trap door, and what was the other thing? It was a trap door, and gosh, what was it? Oh, a cauldron, I think. And it's not, you know. Oh. How you doing? You're done. Yeah, anyways, trapdoor in a cauldron, and I thought that looked pretty cool. We gotta be careful, because if we get creepified here, I'm actually gonna leave that for a ladder. Just find a quick way to get back up. We did the whole thing. All right, let's go back up and look. Yeah, there we go. We have dirt to fill this in. There we go. Oh, how you doing? Oh, he's got a fashionable hat. Well, it is almost spring. You got a very nice spring hat on there, Mr. Zombie. Are you ready to be zombified? Oh! You had no choice, and you never had a chance when you came up against Team 203. I don't think I like those there. Good grief. Can you let me do my episode? All right, while I am working on the next floor of the stable, why don't we do the Saint story? So we'll do the Saint story with a big explosion introduction in 3, 2, 1. Saint Vincent Ferraro was born on January 23rd in 1350 in Spain. His father dreamed that Vincent would grow up to be a famous friar. At 18, Vincent joined the Dominicans. After much study, he became a master of sacred theology. He loved and memorized God's word as well. In 1398, Vincent became very sick from sadness, since the church was divided by a great schism. Our Lord Jesus appeared to Vincent in a vision and healed him. He told Vincent to preach and tell everyone to repent and be holy. For the next 21 years, he preached and worked stupendous miracles throughout Europe, converting thousands of people. Saint Vincent was so successful at building up the church that today he is remembered as the patron of the building trades and of plumbers in particular. He died in 1419. A prayer to Saint Vincent Ferrara for plumbers. Dear Saint Vincent, by opening yourself up to God, you allowed His grace to flow into the lives of many. Dear God, through the prayers of Saint Vincent, bless all plumbers and all who build up your church. In Jesus' name, amen. His feast day is April 5th, and he's the patron of plumbers, Saint Vincent. But yeah, so down here now we have these traps. So what's supposed to happen is when you make some cow babies, they fall down. The babies fall down anyway. They fall down under there. So let's figure out. Another one. They're getting attacked on all sides. Goodbye. Goodbye. Goodbye.
Thunderstorm, go away!
Alright, so this will be where we keep some of the animals. Which means let's actually make this thing here. And then maybe this far wall, maybe this will be. Maybe we'll make this wood with a like a small window inside, maybe. Like that. And, all right, let's do this. Let me, before we go to do our last story, let me just do the walls. We'll just maybe finish this floor as we talk about the last story. So I'll be back in a flip-flop.
Flip-flop, flip-flop.
Hey, so we've got the walls built up around it now. Let's do a complete circle here and see what we like. I think the second floor of this barn, I'm not sure if I like that cobblestone right there, but I think the second floor of the barn I might make a little taller. That cobblestone, see, I like the cobblestone there. Maybe just the cobblestone on this wall needs to be taken out. Probably. I've done a barn in another series where I used red clay, so I might have to actually use red clay. So all the wood blocks will be replaced by red clay. I just like it because it makes a red barn. I do like that better. I think the second floor might have to be a little bit taller, so we're going to make it a little taller. This processing center down here does not have to be that big. I did throw a ladder in here, as you probably saw in the flash forward video. So it brings us up here. We can decide, yeah, maybe the second floor over here. We'll make the hayloft. So we're going to be able to go upstairs, and then, like, right here is maybe where we keep all the hay and stuff. But let's also take the ladder a little further. So the other story, while I'm kind of tinkering around here, the other story was, if you remember, there was these two girls, and one of them was more of a popular girl, and the other girl wasn't. And if you remember, this is a story about making good choices. So the other girl who wasn't very popular had a good friend that she was, you know, kind of like her best friend. But they had this science project in class, and the one girl was able to actually do the project with the popular girl. And as they're having fun and enjoying each other's company, the popular girl starts telling these funny stories about other people in class. So the other girl was tempted because she knew some funny stories about her best friend. And she was in a position where she, you know, she was trying to make up a decision. Should she tell the funny story, the funny stories about her best friend that to this popular girl? Should she tell those stories? The popular girl might think they're funny, and she probably would be want to be more of a friend with her because he'd have these funny stories to share. But then if she did that, she'd kind of be betraying her best friend, who probably doesn't want some of those stories shared with other people. You know, they're personal stories that she hasn't told anybody. So what do you think? And I think we talked about this in class, and I remember correctly, a lot of you believe that you also would not like if one of your best friends told some stories about you to other people. And even if it gets you maybe even if it gets you closer to this other person, you're betraying your actual friend. Maybe it was an embarrassing story that you just told your best friend because you trust them, and they talked you through this embarrassing story or this embarrassing thing in your life. But how mean would it be if your friend took that embarrassing story and then told other people at school, and they only did it so they could become more popular, so they could get along with or have this other person like them? Kind of a bad decision. But you guys, as you get older too, you're going to be put in all sorts of different circumstances where you're going to have to make choices, and that's where the Holy Spirit can guide you. You know deep down inside you have a conscience. A conscience is that part of your soul that's telling you right from wrong. You know what's right from wrong. You deep down inside, with every decision, you know. And a lot of times, one of the tips that someone taught me a long time ago is say it out loud. Say the thing that you want to say. The thing, if in your head you're like, I'm not sure if I should do this, if it's good or bad. Sometimes just saying it out loud, like if you're thinking inside your head, like, I'm going to sneak out tonight and I'm going to do this. And then you say to yourself out loud, I'm going to sneak out of my parents' house tonight so I can hang out with my friend. Just saying that, you're going to go, yeah, that's not a good idea. And you're going to know from right and wrong and go, I need to be good, and I don't think that's going to help me be a better person by doing that. Let me go get the wood over here. So as you get older, you can definitely practice the art of making good choices. And life is going to be hard. Life can be very hard, but you guys can definitely do it. You can get through it. I think I'm going to crisscross these beams, but let's make these a little taller. But I think that is all the time I have for this episode, because we are, I mean, we can tinker around a little bit. We wanted to make those a little taller. But that would mean I have to rip up all of these in general. So, yeah, we'll end it there. We covered the Saint story. We covered making good choices. We talked a little bit about Pentecost. I hope to see you guys next time we're in person, and next time here on YouTube for another episode of Team 203. Be people of do. Get things done today that make yourself a better person and better the lives of the people around you. Godspeed.